guys, welcome back to another episode of Construction Simulator 2015 with me, Brad. I'm 73. We are back for Sunday's episode, and let's see. We have this guy, and we also have, I guess we have the steamroller, or not steamroller, but this digger over here. And I'm kind of wondering if the next time I actually have to dig something out, I might actually give it a try. So I think that's what I'm going to do here. How do I... here we go. Alright. So how are you guys doing? I'm doing alright. Had a kind of a long, you know, gaming day today. I did a 3-hour YouTube live stream, which I had not done that previously. So that's pretty cool. And after that, I actually, during the live stream, my buddy Andy Farmer gifted me a game called Devil's Share, I think it is. And it's a pretty awful game, but I actually recorded a video for it just as a thank you. If you ever are in the mood to gift, you know, to gift me something that you want to see me play, by all means, I think my Steam name is still BradM73. I'm pretty easy to find on there, but yeah, if there's something that you really want to see me play, you know, I'm not outside the realm of being gifted things to play. I wonder if I can turn up here. And, so I want to see if I can dig with this thing instead of using the gigantic excavator. So yeah, he gifted me this game, and I played it, and it's absolutely horrible, but you can beat it in like 10 minutes, if that, probably 5 minutes on a speed run, if not less. And, I just thought it would be funny to kind of do, like a quick let's play on it. Am I going to be able to... I don't know if I can dig this out. Come on. I mean, it's like just right about the right size. Let's, I just want to see. That's as deep as the thing goes. Or maybe that is. So yeah, it actually did dig something out. And then what do I have to do? Do I have to... Okay, I'll tell you what I'll do. Let's get our half pipe truck up here. We're gonna take you over to the construction site. All vehicle locations are blocked, which means I'm gonna have to drive it over. Actually, wait a second. Concrete pump. I back that up. And then if I get my roller out of the way. This episode, we've kind of had to do a little bit of everything in. In all actuality. Or not this episode, but this job. Seems like we've had to do just about everything. Half pipe truck. Now let's see if we can teleport it over there. Yes, please, because I don't want to drive. Okay, let's just I guess we'll just drive it right here. And I guess we'll have to turn around, huh? There we go. Okay, and dump. And as you can see, there's not even like a little sliver of progress. Oh, we gotta go this way. See, the control on this feels reversed. Because when I go, when I push down, I want to tilt, you know, I want to push forward on the thumbstick instead of actually down. Oh my gosh. What the heck? Oh my gosh, no way. No. Well, we actually kind of did it. Is this gonna work? Okay, there's 100%. And we actually kind of got it. As long as I can get up out of here, okay. There we are. And actually, it looks like we dug about half of it out, which is pretty good. So if I can get another scoop like that, we'll be in business. There we go. Okay, now I noticed that we got some new contracts here, so let's look. I guess I have to click on jobs. Special jobs. Power station, that sounds cool. Floodlight masts for stadium. That's what we're gonna do. And then maybe I'll even do the power station. Because that actually seems pretty cool. Alright. Okay. And I kind of got to be careful on this one because I don't want the same thing to happen that happened last time. I don't want the whole thing to tip down. Like that. So I kind of have to go down. And then up. Come on. Get in there. It's pretty tough to drive this thing in here, actually, and not feel like it's getting stuck. Come on. All right, let's just go for it then. Why is this not working? It should be totally working. Oh, come on. Oh. This thing really needs four-wheel drive. Should be four-wheel drive. I think I might be screwed. I think this thing might be actually stuck. Come on, you can do it. Let's go down again. I just want to see. See, I'm getting a little bit of dirt in. Oh, gosh. This is like the worst digger job ever. Come on, get out. Get out. Get out. Go. Go. Come on. Ugh. Are you kidding me? I mean, I'm actually holding the backup button down, and there's nothing happening. Is there a way to maybe lock the differential or something? Does not look like it. Okay. Because otherwise, I don't really know what I need to do. Come on, get out of there. What if I... Wow. This thing's gotta be like all-wheel drive or four-wheel drive. I mean, they're just... I will not accept that these things would not be four-wheel drive or all-wheel drive, one of the two. Okay. I think I'm gonna call it officially stuck. Like right about there, it's kind of getting the most grip. All right. I'm just gonna try to bonk it. You know, kind of knock it to the side a little bit with this truck. And maybe we'll get lucky. I don't know. There. Come on. Boing, boing. Who did the jumping animations? They should be fired. All right, here we go. Yeah, I don't think that's really doing too much, Brad. Alright, through the power of magic, I teleport thee. Alright. Did we get it all? 66% done. Which means we've only got 33%, 34% to go. And if I can dump this off. Whoa. We get one more scoop and not get stuck. That's the big, I don't think I can. I don't think I can get another scoop and not get stuck. I don't see it in my future. No, I don't want to continue digging. There we go. Let's see here. Let's see what we dug. Oh yeah. All right. So let's dig. It says we have to take 10 meters squared. Wait. Stage one. Oh, that's the other job. Oh. Yeah, deliver. Oh, crap. I tell you what I'm going to do. I am going to. Can I. Is it too late to hire somebody? There we go. Okay, so we're going to hire. Because I just don't want to take the dirt over there, to be honest with you. In the meantime, let's see. We have to go to. Let's see here. Where did my trailer go? Build materials dealer, small flatbed truck, sawmill, contact person. So I don't have to drive back here. There's two trailers and a small. Can we get in? Can I teleport into the tower crane? Oh yeah. It says there's two trailers over here. It's those. Huh. It teleported those over here, huh? That's weird. I think I'm going to need the mobile crane for this mission. So, we're just going to drive over to where the soccer field is, or football for all of you Europeans, I guess. Football. All right. Whoa, this truck feels weird. Like the sound doesn't feel right for the truck. Which has kind of been a problem for this game, I think. The audio balance has never been very good on this. So, what are we supposed to do? We're supposed to put, like, some. Oh, there, that actually sounded better. when we drove over the glitched out road there, back there. No. Oh gosh. I'm a safe driver. Don't. Okay, we're at 90 kilometers an hour. Or is that miles per hour? Dun dun dun. Probably miles an hour, you know. Whoa. I'm just waiting to go around a corner and for this thing to like flip over. Where is this contact person? I'm going to assume it's over here somewhere. Oh, I see a guy out there. Okay. have you heard the first team at the Fox Hill Athletic Club has finally moved up, and now look, another job for us to do. Who expected that? It sure took a while. Anyway, what needs to be done? The facilities are still in great shape. True, it was very well done. In any case, several games in the coming season are scheduled in the evening, so the playing field needs floodlights. They have already been manufactured at the steel mill and are waiting there to be transported. Excellent, I'll be on my way. All right. So get four floodlights from the steel mill and place them on the correct position. Okay, so we're gonna need our low boy truck, right? All right. So first of all, we're gonna have to pick up one of these steel mill trailers. So we'll go do that here. Okay, let's back it up nice and slow. Now I can cut the wheel all the way to the right and left bumper. Right. Oh, now I have to raise the outriggers, huh? This is the one. See, that's the other thing too. There's no consistency. Like sometimes you can extend and retract the outriggers with the E and Q key, and sometimes you can't. There we go. Okay, I see a green light here, so we're going to go ahead and make the turn. I'm so glad I finally got those crates out of the way back there. Well, the tiles, you know what I mean. Okay. Oh, great. Now I got the hiccups. Okay, so I think we have to sit that on there. And then we'll just go and buy floodlights for the stadium. First, two times first floodlight element. With number one. Wait, we gotta get two loads of these? Can I buy load number two? Maybe I do have to take two loads. That's what she said. Wait. It's disgusting. Oh my God. Are you serious? Apparently you are serious. I don't even know how to. We have an industrial accident here, guys. Miscellaneous pending orders. I think we're gonna need the mobile crane down here. Take it to the steel mill. Yeah, see the just the audio on this does not seem right. Okay. Okay. Can I pick these up? That's the other question. Space connect cargo. Yes. I can pick them up. Yay. Ooh, that's cool. Which way am I supposed to go here? Hopefully, I'll be able to lay this down. Oh gosh. Do it? Can I do it? Oh man, this is going to be so awesome if I can do this. my gosh, I'm so good. I'm so awesome. I mean, this would be kind of what you would have to do if this were to actually happen in real life, I guess. Where's the other one at? What the heck? Where did it go? What the crap? Where did it go? Well, that's not good. Where is the re where's my re where where's my load? Okay, attaching cargo. The other one probably it probably fell through the ground or something, which is wonderful. Or it came over here and felt like rolled down here and fell into the ocean, which I don't think that it did because I can't get that close to the ocean. So I'm gonna have to guess that it either launched itself into orbit via some bug. As it is nowhere to be found. I'm just checking down here for the fun of it. Yeah, I don't see it anywhere. Has anybody seen a big white tube? Because I need it. Well, this is just wonderful. That's what I get. Well, can I go and get a new load then? Not all elements could be loaded. Wonderful. So where do the elements that can't be loaded go to? That's my question. Well, regardless, we are going to have to go over and hopefully get the low. I mean, I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see. I might be totally screwed on this. I don't know. That light was green, right? Right. It was green. Shh. It was. Oh, here, I can go this way. Now, all four pipes just better be in there when I get over here. They probably won't be, but that would be awesome if they were. So off we go again down. Didn't we drive down here the last episode? This is probably like the best part of the game because I'm getting 94 frames a second and, it kind of looks a lot more like natural terrain than whatever we've been playing. Oh, great. I changed lanes and then the lane goes away. Hello. Well, at least this isn't like Euro Truck where we would actually get tickets for doing this. Okay. Being kind of quiet because I'm concentrating. I'm like a NASCAR driver, but in a vehicle that's not NASCAR and not very stable, or at least not as stable as a NASCAR. I had to, years ago, it's probably been over 10 years ago, I had to drive a moving van for a friend of mine. Well, actually, it was a friend of my mother's. And I only had to drive it, oh, I don't know, 10 or 15 miles. I had to pick it up. I had to pick it up here where I live, like just down, like 2 miles from, 3 miles from where I live. And then I had to drive it kind of up, like over to where my dad lives, kind of near there. And then from there, I had to, okay, where are we supposed to put these things? Okay, I'm seeing like, oh yeah, okay, I think I see him now. All right, so I guess we will have to drive these out like so. And then we'll have to detach the cargo, I'm assuming. So there's our two things there. Get in our mobile crane. And I still do not see any pipes anywhere. So let's just go ahead. I'm going to fold this up. Let's go ahead and teleport it over to the construction site 2. Holy Moses, that was expensive to get it over here. $432. I'm pretty sure that was dollars and not cents. Whoa. We did a pretty good job on this court. I mean, I remember painting the thing and everything. Okay, no, I didn't actually do that. All right. Okay. Oh, wonderful. So this. Okay. Let's just pull this right out here. And then I'm really hoping this will reach out there, because if not, I'm screwed. I think it will, though. Sweet. Man. Exactly like in real life. Not at all. I get kind of like this sneaking feeling, though, or this sinking feeling that we're going to have to restart this job. That's the only bad thing. Because I just have a feeling that those other two poles or whatever, light posts or whatever, are not going to reappear. Okay. I still think this thing is pretty cool. This is probably one of the nicest pieces of equipment to use in the game, I think. All right. So now we're going to have to drive back over there and just hope that we can buy two more of these light posts. Because if we can't, we're screwed. And not in a good way. Right. I'm gonna go a different way on the way back though, because there's one way that I've driven that I haven't gone before. And we're just gonna pass everybody because, you know. This guy's probably turning to the right. And I'm going to turn to the left here because I've never driven down this road. And I think, and I could be absolutely wrong, but I think this will actually take us back to where, kind of where the steel mill is. So I don't know. We'll find out. The green line is telling me to go back. I don't want to go back. Watch it be like a dead end up here, and then I'll really be screwed. What do I have to do for this other job? Stage 9, drain pipes. Oh, I'm just gonna hire a worker for that, because that. That is not gonna be as fun as what we're doing here, I don't think. And then that other job will be finished. And we'll just have to worry about this job. And I am actually worried about it. Kind of, not really. I guess I could have turned left back there, but. Oh, look at the trees right there. There, you'd see the graphics glitch through them. Dadgummit. Just when you thought this game had better graphics than Grand Theft Auto V. I tell ya. All right, cross your fingers, guys. Wee-wah! Floodlight mast for the stadium. One times first. Yes. Where is the other one? Dude, we are so screwed. It can't. It's like the other one is out there somewhere. It's probably in the harbor. Sawmill. I wish it showed us like where we just have like, you know, random loads sitting around. I am just looking here in my home lot to see if maybe. Oh, there it is, right over there. Sweeter than honey, best peach. Wait. All right, so we're gonna need the lowboy truck over here. You never thought that this was gonna be this much of a disaster, did you? Well, that's actually good because I was really thinking that we were gonna have to actually completely reset the whole, the whole thing, and that we would be absolutely shafted. So the fact that we're not makes me feel much better. Okay. I feel like I'm driving in circles, though. But, I mean, come on, I've never done this before. I li literally, like, every single one of these episodes is, like, I've never done it ever, ever before. The episode. No joke. Okay. Detach cargo. All right, so mobile crane. Teleport to home base. Yes. Oh no, I don't want to teleport it here. Yes. We are just having like the time of our lives in this episode, I'm telling you guys. You never thought you would see this much fail in one episode. Actually, I don't know. There's been plenty of fail. There's been plenty of fail in this mission or in this series, I think. Okay. New contracts are available. Okay. Okay. And lift that up. Okay. This was really weird. Okay. Yikes, yikes, yikes. No. Okay, and okay. Phew. All right, let's fasten this cargo up. Okay. Man, I didn't think I was going to be able to get that. Oh, look, there's more of those roofing tiles there. I can breathe again. All right, so back onto the highway for us then. How are we doing on time? I haven't been paying attention. Oh gosh. No, not into the river. Oh. Okay, I'm going to assume that all of our pipes are in there or whatever. Poles, yeah, poles. Get out of my way! It's just like I would drive in the real world. Not. I swear, like, it's been almost 2 years ago, but, or when was it? Was it th no, yeah, it was like a year and a half, over a year and a half ago. In November, it'll be 2 years when, I was talking on the on Skype with Thomas Sweden and Stockoglaws about the backup server for the Teddy Bear live, the first Teddy Bear. I don't know if it's the first or the second or which one. One of the Teddy Bear live streams, the one that happened, I guess, in 2013. And I'm driving up. I had to go out to the farm that day, and there's this crate, this girl in front of me. She's like tailgating this truck, and when I say tailgating, she was right on the back bumper of this truck. It was like like one of those trucks that goes around and like cuts limbs down and trees and stuff. And then we come up to this gas station, kind of out in the middle of the country. And the speed limit through there is like, I don't know, 45, 50 miles an hour. And this girl didn't even clear, and she just makes a left turn into this, across the lane into this gas station. And sure enough, there was somebody going the other way. She slammed on her brakes. They just pretty much went about head on. Not quite head on, but kind of at an angle because she was, turning. And of course, I was like right there. I mean, I was 60 feet away, and I even knew. Matter of fact, I slowed down because I could see this girl. I'd been following her, and she'd been, she tried. She passed me, and I was telling the guys, I'm like, this girl's gonna get herself killed. And I jumped out of the. I stopped, pulled the van off the side of the road. I'm cussing. I'm like, holy shmear! And Thomas and Stocko are like. They didn't know what the heck was going on. For all they knew, I just got into an accident. I slam the door, jump out, and like I'm ha running ha to the car to help. And my first instinct is, or my f not well my first instinct, my first thought was to help these people. My second thought was, oh my God, what if I get to the car and it's basically like brains everywhere? And thankfully, it wasn't. And both all the people ended up being just fine, but that was pretty freaking scary. I have to say, it was not nice. I would not ever want to go through that again. And please, people, when you're driving, even when you're in a hurry, nothing is worth your life. Nothing is worth like being in such a hurry that you're gonna kill yourself over. And this young girl almost killed two people, and luckily they both, all three of them walked away from it. The girl, she was, I think she was even more shook up than the two guys were, and the poor guys, they had this brand new car, like the poor kid, he was like 16 or 17. He's like, I just got my driver's license, and this is my new car, you know? And so, and of course, it's probably totaled. I don't know if it was. It was in pretty bad shape, though. And, you know, so just, you know, if I reach one of you guys and I save a life, then that's my duty is done. Well, my duty's probably in the toilet, but anyway. sorry, I'm not trying to make light of it. But yeah, it was pretty messed up, and I am a very insanely careful driver now that I had to go through that. I mean, even though I was fine, you know, I didn't get in a wreck or anything. I mean, it was pretty, you know, of course, then I had to wait around for several hours as I was a witness and I had to make a statement and all that other stuff. But yep. No, they never, nobody ever called me about it. Like, you know, thankfully I never had to show up to court or anything. So, hopefully they both had insurance. Okay, am I going to be able to get into this? Yes, I am. All right. All right, we're almost done, guys. We are almost done. Dun 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 dun. Though, where is the rest of the, I mean, we're just putting up. Wait, what am I doing? Oh yeah, there we go. We're just putting up this pole here. No. Oh, phew. I thought that was like the extent of it. There we go. Yay, stage finished. Now what? Get 4 second floodlight elements. Oh my gosh, really? Oh, wow, that's gonna be tall. Okay. Well, let's see. Is this gonna be able to fit all the way up there from here? Guess it will, huh? Man, this thing's got reach. Look at that. Okay, that's right there at the edge of its reach, for sure. But if I park it right there next to the soccer thing, it's definitely going to be able to reach both. Excuse me. I'm like drinking Coca-Cola, which I don't really do that often, and now I'm like been burping. So if you've been hearing like, you know, that's probably me burping. Well, unfortunately, we don't have time to do the rest of this job, so we'll have to come back in the next episode on Thursday and finish this up. Guys, thank you so much for watching another episode of Construction Simulator 2015 with me, Brad M73. As always, please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And we'll see you guys next time. Bye for now.